Hey, what's up guys, Carnage here for Blame Rennie, and today I'm going to show you how to unlock accomplishments easily on FIFA 12. So there are three basic methods to unlocking your Virtual Pro's accomplishments quick and easy, the primary one being the standard method. The standard method should be the first method you consider using when wanting to unlock an accomplishment. It can be used to unlock most accomplishments within FIFA 12, it's very simple, and also doesn't require any assistance from any other person. The first thing you will need to do is log on to EA's Creation Center with the account linked to your gamertag or PSN, then bookmark the BYE boosting team. The link to the Creation Center is in the description. Also make sure you bookmark the official BYE boosting team by WA Carnage. Next you need to get on FIFA 12 and download the BYE boosting team. Once you have downloaded the BYE boosting team, you can tweak them in team management. The main change you will want to make is moving all but one defender into the opposition's half. You can also adjust tactics, as well as opting to replace some of the starting 11 with defenders on the bench. The defenders on the bench have 99 aggression and a high tendency to make reckless slide tackles, meaning that you can earn free kicks more easily if you so wish. For step 4, simply start an exhibition match with the team your Virtual Pro is on against a CPU-controlled BYE boosting team. Now you can edit your formation and the game settings. There isn't anything vital to do to your formation other than ensuring your Virtual Pro is in a desired position, but there are a number of vital game settings to adjust. Besides the standard match settings and rules that you can adjust, such as half length and offsides, in FIFA 12 you can now adjust the actual gameplay. Not only can you edit the gameplay elements such as shot speed, sprint speed, goalkeeper ability and pass error rate, but you can determine what team shot speed etc. gets changed. So to make accomplishments even easier for you, you can give your team high sprint speed and shot power, and give your opponent's team slow sprint speed and bad goalkeeper ability. You can give yourself an as big advantage as you want, and it will not affect your ability to unlock accomplishments. Here are the settings I recommend for unlocking Virtual Pro accomplishments. Just remember that you may want to adjust the settings you see here, depending on what accomplishment you are trying to get. One more thing I should point out before you start the match is the difficulty setting. Bronze accomplishments can be unlocked on any difficulty, silver accomplishments can be unlocked on semi-pro or higher difficulty, whilst gold accomplishments will only unlock on world class or legendary difficulty. No matter what accomplishment you are trying to get, I recommend putting the difficulty on world class because the BYE boosting team should be pushovers, and so you might as well work towards gold accomplishments whilst getting any other bronze or silver accomplishment. You're now playing against a team of rated 1, fat, 4'11 players with one defender and gameplay sliders severely out of their favour. Unlocking accomplishment should be no problem at all.
He's in the clear! And the shot at the end of it. Oh, that's a fantastic goal!
That goal was made masterfully by Luka Modric.
The next method for unlocking accomplishments is the two controller method. The two controller method is very similar to the standard method, but allows you to control the BYE boosting team, which will help you set up certain scenarios that you may need for unlocking certain accomplishments. The major drawback to this method, however, is that you can only unlock bronze accomplishments with it. Steps 1 to 3 are identical to steps 1 to 3 of the standard method, but if you wish, you can skip step 3 as you can change the BYE boosting team's formation during step 5. For step 4, you'll want to start an exhibition match as your Virtual Pros team against a second controller-controlled BYE boosting team. Step 5 is the same as step 5 for the standard method, but now you can edit the BYE boosting team's formation using the second controller before the match, as well as drawing, which will save you having to go back through the menus. Just don't forget to adjust the gameplay sliders and rules, as these will help you out a lot. Step 6 is again the same as step 6 for the standard method, but this time you can control the BY boosting team to create certain scenarios which can help you unlock accomplishments that you may find tricky to get using the standard method. The final basic method for unlocking accomplishments is the online method. This method is almost identical to the two controller method, but this one allows you to unlock silver and gold accomplishments as well as bronze. The downside is that it requires a second person, which can effectively double the amount of time it takes to get accomplishments if you return the favour. Also, you should note that only the player who invites the other player can unlock accomplishments. The second player cannot unlock accomplishments online. If your friend wants to unlock accomplishments online, then he or she will have to invite you to an online match, but you will not be able to unlock accomplishments in the same match. Steps 1 to 3 are the same as the standard method, except you will need your friend to bookmark, download and edit the BY boosting team instead. Next, you will want to invite your friend to an online friendlies match, and play as your virtual pros team and have your friend select the BY boosting team. Before the match, of course make sure that your virtual pro is in your desired position, and that your friend is using the right formation and tactics with the BY boosting team to make things as easy as possible for you. Just like with the other methods, you're playing against a weak team, but now the team is controlled by your friend, meaning you can create specific scenarios to help you get some of the tricky accomplishments, whether they be bronze, silver or gold. And those are your three basic methods for unlocking accomplishments in FIFA 12 easily. Remember that the standard method is your go-to method, and you should always try to unlock accomplishments with that before trying the other methods. If that fails though, the other two methods should help you out. Don't forget to thumbs up and subscribe for more HD FIFA 12 tutorials, and I'll see you guys next time.